Poverty puts a tremendous strain on people. Years of being deprived of one's basic needs, both physical and psychological, and yes, that includes the need to enjoy life, the need to have fun from time to time. And years of being deprived of that can really make a person crazy, and it can render a person with more problems than he or she may have started out with. In fact, one can only ask the question, if a homeless person does have an alcohol or drug problem, or a mental illness, how is that person going to change and overcome those obstacles when he or she is homeless? What is the incentive to stop drinking, to stop using drugs, when you're destitute?
Okay, so if anybody wants to promote a shelter, I say they go spend a day or night in the shelter. I've slept in shelters here, in New York, San Francisco, all over the United States.
And what are they like?
And they're worse than being homeless.
I know you said like it was a bad experience, and can you describe one experience in particular where you lived in the shelter? Can you describe what it was like, what the beds were like?
Well, I mean, they're just mats, like jail mats. They're like the kind of community mats you use in jails. And you just line people up row by row, hundreds of people in a row.
Been to rescue mission?
Yeah.
Do you know, like, if we wanted to do any shooting inside?
You'd have to go through our media department.
Your media department?
Yeah.
Is there anyone we can talk to now?
They're going to tell you the same thing I am. That you need to clear this with Greta Walker.
Who's Greta Walker?
She is the PR person for Denver Rescue Mission.
Who is it that a homeless shelter can afford to hire a PR agent?
What amazes me is you got these things that say, don't give to homeless people, give it to us, to this corporate whatever like that. Okay, that's a combination of the city and the county and the state and a bunch of corporations. City and county and state haven't passed a balanced budget in decades.
So where do you
government
think all
that money's
going?
Government is $8 trillion in debt.
Really? Where do you think all that money's going that's being put in those
I don't know, but I know that they're more incompetent than any homeless person alive. There's no homeless person that owes $8 trillion.
What's really interesting to me in working on this documentary is that many people we interviewed were living with their friends or their relatives because they could not afford housing. And if it weren't for those friends or relatives who let them stay with them, they would be homeless. And yet, some of these same people would pass judgment on the homeless. So why is that? Why is it that so many Americans today are struggling financially? And why is it that so many of us who are struggling financially, who are just one or two paychecks away from being homeless, are so judgmental of the homeless? What would happen if we stopped passing judgment? What would happen if we started caring? Would it mean that we'd have to do something? Thank you. preoccupied with just survival, how to get enough money for food, for clothes that I need, for health care, just basic necessities for survival. And after a while, you just forget about your hopes and dreams. You forget about what you want out of life, and you forget how to enjoy life and how to dream. You just become obsessed with just mere survival, and you lose your spirit. And some people never get that spirit back again. They're completely lost.